Hi guys, how are you? Welcome to my YouTube channel Vision Innovative. So today we discuss how do penguins keep warm. If you are not subscribed my channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon for latest video notification. So penguins are an archetypal animal of the cold. They survive in the harshest and most frigid climates on earth, where they can often be the only life around. How do they do this? Being warm-blooded, they cannot let their own body temperature fall. Warm-blooded animals in cold climates are pretty large. Even the smallest Antarctic birds are on the large side, and the smallest Antarctic penguin, the rock hopper, is a fairly hefty 2.5 kg. The Adelie and Emperor penguin of the deep south and larger still. Adult weights are 5 kg for the Adelie and 30 kg for the Emperor, a similar size to an overweight 10 years old child, but with a man size chest measurement. Large animals have a smaller surface area, volume ratio, and so the less relative area there is to lose heat. If you imagine these are simple cubic warm-blooded animals, then the small cube has 3 times the surface area per unit of volume compared to the large cube. If each of these are both warmer than the outside temperature, the small cube will cool down much more quickly. Somewhat surprisingly, it does not matter what the shape is. The principle stays the same for all geometrical identical shapes, including animal shapes. This means that for identically shaped animals of different size, the large one will always keep its temperature more easily than the smaller one. Being big means being warmer. Warm up warm and conserve heat. Penguins have feathers to keep them warm, right? Well, partly right, feathers work on land, but in the water, where penguins spend quite a bit of their lives, they are not so good. What really keeps penguin warm in the sea is a subcutaneous layer of the fat. This fat layer also serves as a valuable energy store, as we will see later. Extremely fur and feathers are the most efficient insulators on a wet for a wet basis, but can be ruffled by wind and are much less useful when wet. A penguin's fat layer is what protects them against the cold while in the sea. On the land, however, their feathers fulfill the function of keeping them warm. Penguins' feathers are not like the large flat feathers the flying birds have. They are soft with an underlayer of fine woolly down. Penguin feathers are also very good at shedding water when the bird emerges from the sea. They overlap and give a good streamlined effect in the water and excellent wind-shedding abilities when on the land. When it gets very cold, penguins can puff their feathers out to trap more air for even better insulation. When it gets too hot, they floppy their feathers out even more so that to trapped warm air can escape and enable the penguin to cool down. Penguins have the highest density of feathers per unit area of any bird. This first layer is the best form of internal insulation while devised by Mother Nature, and therefore the best way to keep warm in water. It keeps all warm-blooded cold water animals operational down to minus. Why this temperature? Because that is when seawater freezes. You can't get seawater colder than what without it being solid. A penguin can have up to 30% of its body weight as blubber. Penguins have 2 areas where their body is very poorly insulated and where they can lose a lot of heat. These are their flippers and their feet. These regions give penguins at the same time a problem and a solution. A problem because of the heat loss and a solution because they can be used for cooling down. It is all well and good being brilliantly insulated when it's very cold, but when you use a lot of energy and so generate heat, or the temperature rises, not being able to dump that had become a big problem in itself. The solution is quite elegant. The muscles that operate feet and flippers are not located in the feet and flippers, but deeper in the warmer region of the penguin's body. The feet and flippers are moved to tendons that pass through them and attach the bones of the toes, ankle and wrist like a sort of remote operation by wire and string. This means that it does not matter much if the feet and flippers get really cold, as they can still be operated normally by muscles in regions that are at normal body temperature and so still floppy functional. Penguins have a heat and exchange blood flow to these regions called reti mirabile. The warm blood entering the feet flows past cold-blooded living, so warming it up in the process and cooling the blood entering at the same time. The same sort of thing happens in the flippers. Blood in the feet flippers is kept significantly colder than in the rest of the body much of the time. By the time the blood re-enters the rest of the body, it has been warmed up and so does not have so great an effect in cooling the core of the temperature. At low temperature or when in the sea, the blood flow to feet and flippers is very low, so minimizing heat loss. When the penguin needs to lose heat quickly, the blood flow to these extremities is increased and so loss of warm blood enters them, which cools quickly, so dumping excess heat rapidly and efficiently. The males endure the worst conditions looking after the egg on land for months on end, while the females build up their reserves by feeding at sea. By the time of female return, the males have lost 40% of their body weight. Relief when it arrives is far from immediate, as after the male hands up the egg to the female, he faces a march to the sea that typically 50 to 100 km, but can be up to 200 km. His total period sea to sea before he can catch any leaf food again living on stored fat can be 115 days or more. Emperor penguins can recapture up to 80% of the heat escaping through their breath thanks to the complex heat exchange system in their nasal passages. Penguins can cool down by moving to shaded areas and by panting. Penguins can ruffle their feathers. They break up in the insulating air layer next to the skin, so releasing the warm air and cooling them down. Penguins can increase their heat loss by holding the flippers away from the body, so both surface of the flippers are exposed to air releasing heat. So this is all for today's video. If you like to see more videos, then please like, share and comment. And please subscribe my channel. Thank you.